Good morning to our friends and to our lecturer, Mr. Pradeep, our lecturer. And today our topic is Domino Pizza, and this is our case study. So my name is Cynthia, and before that, I would like to introduce to my members as well.
Hello, my name is Tomek.
Hello, my name is Zhou Shi.
Hello, my name is Lin Ji.
Hello, my name is Chu Ho Yang.
Okay, so this is the history, a very short one that I'm gonna let you know. And this is how what they have been doing for the past few years. And okay, so this is my topic. Yeah, advantage and disadvantage of being an employee and self-employed. Okay, employee receive a steady paycheck where they work in a company and they get a fixed salary income for every month, and their employee can manage their financial differently because they receive a regularly income. They get benefit including healthcare, for example, health insurance as well. Working a regular schedule, they work in a company where they have a sorted schedule for them. So after that, maybe they can work, like for example, maybe to 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and then they can go and pick up their kids from school, or they can go home and take care of their parents as well. Get professional development is where they can work with a group of employees where they have different skills and everything. So these employees are able to build their own knowledge and skill within the company as well. Have co-worker where you can work with together with your other employees, and you can get their more information and benefit to a collaboration working environment. Are given to rewards and recognition. It's where they pay increment, promotion, and also awards. So this is the disadvantage of being an employee. Limited income is where they work overtime, then only they can get extra payment. If they don't, they don't get any payment. So it's just very little, limited. So the job security is where this company, let's say they have this position, for example, where you have a lot of competitor. So you won't guarantee yourself that say you will work this for life. That's why for all these jobs, there's always 100% not very guaranteed for you, because you will always work with like competing towards others as well. Job security, limited development scope is where they have employee works with few choices for careers progression and only advance within a very specific industry. So they only very limited, and then they have no choices as well. And dependency is where employee with a big family have added pressure and can feel a growing dependency on their job as their family grow on expand. So this is the advantage of being self-employed. They have flexibility where they work by their own, and they have they decide they can work what time they want also can. It's very flexible for them. Are their own bosses where they own themselves a boss because they work alone. So they pick their own customer as well. So let's say they don't need to choose a very choosy or fussy customer as well. So they can pick whatever customer they want. Can be more productive. Decide your own working hour, because it's very flexible, so they can work wherever they want, and how long is it, it's up to them. And the cost of business are manageable. So this is the disadvantage of being self-employed. The disadvantage of this is they will get stressed because they work alone in this company if they own their own company, okay? So long working hour is where they only work for, let's say, their project is due date is coming, so they have to work longer time. And time not working is time not earning as well. So every time they have to work for non-stop. And they don't have any benefit because this is self-employed. It's the only company. So I would like to pass to my next member for the next slide.
Hello everyone. Advantages and disadvantages of the small sole trader and the sizable limited company chains within the restaurant sector. Okay, full control. The advantages of being a sole trader are immense, not least because the owner has full control over the business. For dynamic operation as well as hope a large they wish to grow it. Less restrictive under regulations. A sole trader does not need to complete many of the forms and accounting information that limited companies need to produce. No staffing management required. As there are no staff on hand, the owner also takes all of the profits made by the business, and all financial information is kept private. Fast decision meetings. Decision making is also fast, as it's just the owner who decides where the business is heading and whether not to undertake any work and where and when they will work. Lower accounting cost. Accounting generally charges less for company accounts and advice costs. There is less work to undertake. You just need to complete profit and loss account. Reserve and then balance sheet and cash flow. Disadvantages of the small sole trade. Full financial liability if things go wrong. The main disadvantages is that you, as the owner of the business, are solely for any consequences of business failure or any liability. For example, injuring a customer or damaging property. Also, portray you as a small company. It may also be quite difficult to do a larger job, not only because a large corporation and many staff can work and offers, but most organizations want to work with a business that only has a staff of. And the business stops if you are unable to work. you may also need to think about what would happen if you, as a business owner, were to become sick or had an accident, so you refuse to work. Tax, VAT, and liability. Sole traders still need to properly account for all sales expenses and the profits for any income tax and the national insurance levels and early prices. Advantage of the sizable limited companies, limited liability. It is the biggest benefit of running your business as a limited company. Professional stats. A company, professional and corporate image is created by a limited, those passing the value of the business. Tax efficiency and plenty. Companies zones are only labeled for the value of the unpaid shares of personal current warranties rather than the full extent of the company. Pension. Okay. Companies provide the opportunity of this pre-tax trading income company pension exam as the opposite to investing this strong income in a personal person after the election of business tax and the personal tax. Okay. Disadvantages of the sizable limited companies. Okay. About the complex account. Complex and restrictive rules governing the account and bookkeeping of limited companies. For example, the company is expected to produce a year's account. Incorporating a double entry format become a balance sheets and all the months. Restricted capital raising. For pre-rate limited company, there is a restriction on the rising of capital via sale of shares. Division of powers. Due to the nature of public limited companies, and sometimes disputes will arise between directors and shareholders as their ideas of what is best for the company. Okay, I will do my comments for my colleagues.
Oh, yeah.
Small firms are often owned by a little numbers of people. This gives an advantage of help sharing profits among the owners, which increase the share of return. Besides this, one has an advantage of having authority to make all decisions. One doesn't have to depend on anyone else to make the decision. The area of cooperation and the nature of the business is decided by the individuals, depending on one's profit, depending on one's interests. Franchising has its own merits and demerits. When it comes to motivation, the franchising offer brand to entrepreneurs. Franchising is offered by those outlets which have decades history of serving their clients, which make it easily to introduce among the public. Furthermore, the cost of advertisement is eliminated as franchisers offer a national campaign and charge within the franchising fees. The entrepreneur will have more loyal customers through franchises as they are usually repeated customers. Lastly, when someone is new to the industry, he looks for administrative and material support. Through franchising, the entrepreneur is free from the hassles that one may have to face on launching the new business. The franchising has get a reputation among the customers and the stakeholders. These are the aspects which motivate customers and which motivate which motivate an individual to consider franchises as an option to initiate or launch into the industry. Okay, here's my customer, Zhang Lin.
Hello,
this is my topic and my answer is absolutely yes. The franchising are usually considered to work within the interest of franchisers. As their relationship is termed as a commercial marriage. The difference in this relation is that I've got the seniority or dominance, which in this relation is given to franchisor the term of the relationship and already there, which determines the right and obligations as the term with each of the party. The franchisees is the one who is the direct toward department individual in interrelationship to things for themselves. And they are assumed to complain against big competition by entering into the market with the possible lowest investment and risk. The franchisor needs more visibility at the end of the franchise. However, in this case, there are problems preventing related to the fulfillment of the dual obligations, as either side negotiations is only reminding in such kind of relationships. Next, we introduce my another friend to continue.
Skill and experience within the field. For me, the flight set will be more secure and playful before initiating the particular business. I really have the better support that will help me in understanding the problems and feel dignity in the restaurant business. Instead of worry about the business, and mentoring the food. Quality and actor on the menu. Arabi Tyrotter Tori Address Dream Management as food and the problems.